EA Sports. It's in the game.
If it's in the game, EA Sports, it's in the game.
MVP Baseball 2003.
Hello everyone, welcome to the beautiful new ballpark in
We're coming
Cleveland,
to you from the Great American
Cincinnati,
Ballpark,
Ohio.
Major League Baseball's newest venue, where the Cincinnati
America's
Reds begin playing in 2003. We welcome you to this exhibition matchup featuring the Arizona Diamondbacks and the Cincinnati Reds. Hi again everybody, I'm Dwayne Kuiper, joined by Mike Krukow for tonight's MVP baseball game. The first pitch is just moments away. Mike, let's talk about the key to tonight's game.
Ken Griffey Jr. could be the difference in this game. He drives and runs with great regularity, so they have to be careful how they pitch him with runners on.
To lead off today's game, here's Tony Womack. Looking forward to a good game, and we're set to go. Starting for the home team, Ryan Dempster.
Last season, Ryan Dempster went 10-13 with a 5.38 ERA for the Marlins and the Reds.
He winds and throws. Ball low and away. That one misses inside. The pitch. Womack hits the ball to right field. Caught by the center fielder.
Griffey Jr. eased over and made the play. Nothing to it, Cut.
One down, bases empty. It's a foul ball. The 0-1. There's a foul ball.
Soda, get your ice cold soda pop right here.
Grounded down the left side. The ball drops. He beats it out for an infield single. Luis Gonzalez had one of the greatest seasons in National League history in 2001. He hit 325, 57 home runs, 142 RBIs, and 419 total bases.
Yeah, those are MVP numbers. The only problem is there was a guy named Bonds who had a better year than that.
The thing is, you know, Luis Gonzalez put up 57 home runs that season. But guess what? In 2001, he won the World Series. And that's what it's all about, folks. I know Bonds won the MVP in 2001, but Luis Gonzalez was the heart and soul of the Arizona Diamondback team. Excited to see him in Dodger Blue this year. It's just not the same without Mr. Gonzalez.
Council is taking off. He's in safely at second.
The runner got a great jump at first base and stole it easily.
But when you're quick as this guy, Craig Council.
He's stretching his lead
no
off the bag.
To me that he stole that base. Now, Craig Council has been known for stealing bases. But you know one year he stole 20 bases? I think it was 99.
And here's the delivery. Strike on that pitch.
But this team really needs a big hit from this guy right here to knock in that runner from second.
There's a line drive. That one drops in for a hit. That's a base hit.
There was no doubt about that one. Base hit all the way.
Steve Finley takes his turn. He delivers. Fastball down in the zone, strike.
The pitcher has to be focused on keeping the ball down the strike zone. A ground ball here gets him a double play.
Well, Steve Finley's been around baseball for a very long time. Been in the league for almost 19 plus seasons. And he's played for such teams as the San Francisco Giants. He's played for the Arizona Diamondbacks, the California Angels, Los Angeles Angels. Both times he's played for that team. And now you see him in Arizona, but he played there. And now currently he's playing for the Colorado Rockies. And Steve Finley, guys like pushing 41, and he's still getting the job done. He's in great mint condition. He knows what he's doing. He goes out there, he works hard. And you know what? And these managers around Major League Baseball just look at Steve Finley and say, hey, these guys are getting better at 40. I mean, come on. I mean, in the old days, was like, when you hit 30 years old, it's over, baby. It's over.
Dempster throws strike two call. The ball is hit out to center. Caught by Griffey Jr. The runner tags from third. The runner scores on the sacrifice fly.
Finley gave the fielder no challenge at all in that routiner.
Danny Bautista steps in at the plate. Fastball at the knees for a strike. It's a line drive. Incredible catch.
Lopez used every inch of his body to make that play. That is an outstanding effort.
Heading into the bottom of the inning, the Reds trail by one. The D-backs are known for their pitching, especially the Johnson-Schilling duo. But last year, they also had the National League's best offense and were the only team in the senior circuit to exceed 800 runs.
Hey, they're a good team. I mean, it gets overshadowed sometimes because their pitchers are so dominant, but this team is a good one all the way through. This guy right here will beat you if you get that ball up in the zone.
Swung and a miss at the high and tight fastball. Here's the pitch. He sends this pitch to right field. Bautista puts it away.
Lopez lofted that ball too much, and the fielder was able to stroll over and make the play easy.
Fastball misses wide.
Well, the funny thing about Aaron Boone, he's always had a good, good bat.
A ball.
In 2003, he hit the biggest home run in his career.
The way he's capable of throwing.
And he delivers.
New York Yankees.
He gets a strike with the fastball at the knees.
And I think it was the NLCS. Knock up the Boston Red Sox.
Boom, taking in a strike, even to count in two. And the delivery. Swing and a miss, strike three.
He could not catch up with strike three. See you later.
Austin Kearns steps into the box. Chases one low and misses for a strike. The pitch. Tries to golf one, but missed. That's a strike.
Oh, that's a perfect slide. Some guy's trying to throw it too hard, but he was real careful and got a great late snap to it.
One ball, two strikes. Hit the other way to the right side. Johnson with a 1-2-3 inning. The Diamondbacks lead the Reds by one. Last year, the Arizona Diamondbacks won 98 games and their second consecutive NL West title.
When the Diamondbacks take the field, they think win every time they cross the line.
Well, the thing I love about the Arizona Diamondbacks,